Continuing coverage now of the bombings in Boston, Cincinnati hit a handful of residents who ran that marathon. WLWT News 5's Allison Montoya live at CVG. Allison, you just talked with runners who say they're happy to be home.
Yeah, that's right, Lisa. These runners arrived here at CVG around 8:30 this morning, and collectively, all these runners told me, of course, they are happy to be home and they cannot wait to see their family members. And of course, it was an emotional homecoming for all.
And then as I began walking, there were runners in the street crying, people upset, people wandering around, kind of, you know, like zombies, kind of dazed and confused. Lots of emergency vehicles, lots of police presence at that time. It was upsetting.
And that's Jane Mays, a dentist out of Hyde Park, and she ran the 5K a day earlier before the marathon and says yesterday she was about a half a mile away from the finish line when the bombs went off, and then she was diverted from the course. She says this will not stop her from running the Flying Pig Marathon, also on the plane this morning. Erin Lowry from Loveland, she finished the marathon 30 minutes before the bombs went off. Just like Jane, Erin cannot wait to wrap her arms around her family.
I want to hug my kids. I want to hug my boys. You know, an 8-year-old passed away yesterday, and he was probably cheering on his mom or his dad, waiting for him to come in, and I can't imagine. I'm so glad they weren't there.
Now, Erin will also be running the Flying Pig with Jane, and they said, though, that they are very hesitant about allowing their family members there to cheer them on. Also, we talked with another runner on this plane here this morning that arrived at 8:30. She said she has different thoughts on if she will, in fact, run the Flying Pig. Hear from her later on tonight, starting at 5 o'clock. Reporting live from CVG, Allison Montoya, WLWT News 5.